commence work before the end of the month from the Kaduna Kano rail line. So we're doing our best in that regard. But there's a danger. I won't even tow the line that others are towing. Well, I'm not quantifying the material cost. What I'm quantifying will be the lives that will be lost. Now, I want to say to you, and I will mention some areas, when you cut off a rail track, I was told by the, I must call his name so that if it is wrong, people will call him. The MD of railway says it takes, if you want a train to stop at Ministry of Works, you must stop it now, 800 meters before it gets to Ministry of Works. So imagine that a driver of a rail track is driving and suddenly runs into a track that has been severed. What happens? It will derail. And if it derails, people will die. Each coach for now in Nigeria carries 85 passengers. And sometimes we carry 14, we take 14 coaches. Sometimes it can get to 20, sometimes 10. So imagine if you're driving a train of 14 coaches or 20, and they're full, 84 to 85 passengers per track, per coach. If it derails and we lose, even if it's 10 persons per coach, can you quantify how many persons that would have died? And then blocked the track. I don't know what he was doing that he had to drive across the track. But as the train was coming, the driver was helpless. He ran into the truck, destroyed the locomotive, destroyed some coaches. Luckily, they've not handed over to us, but we, insurance plus the man, they had to pay for it. So it's not about the cost. It's about the lives that will be lost because of the few interests that will be protected. Now, I don't want to bore you too by telling you the number of tracks that we have in the country. Maybe let me repeat that so that you know how much danger we are in. Currently, we have a 193 kilometer track from Lagos to Ibadan in the old narrow gauge, which was built between 1898 to 1901. You have from Ibadan to Jeba, you have from Jeba to Mina, you have from Mina to Baro, Port Harcourt to Enugu, Enugu to Makurdi, Kafanchan to Jos, Kuru to Bauchi, Bauchi to Gombe, Gombe to Maiduguri. All these are the old lines. Now we have the operational standard gauge lines that are from Abuja to Kaduna, Warri to Itabe, and Lagos to Ibadan. All of them put together, one is 187 kilometers, that's Abuja to Kaduna. The Warri to Itabe is 255 kilometers. And Lagos to Ibadan is about 186 kilometers. Now, the last one I saw was Warri to Itabe. Fortunately, it wasn't the main line. It was the side line that the gentleman went to cut off. And they are doing it with foreign partners. In Jos, we arrested a Chinese company that bought those tracks from them, went to court. Court found them guilty. Ask them, what is the consequence? 200,000 naira. That's the law. So I want to stretch this to show you, as I said, I'm going to take some extra minutes, to show you that it is just not enough to say stop. It is that there must be consequences. And 200,000 naira consequence is not enough. Now, what are the other economic consequences? There are those who use our trains for freight services. They include Lafarge Cement, flour mills, bonded container traffic for ICNL and APMT, to the track material, movement of an analysis petroleum product, miscellaneous traffic, fertilizer movement, pipe movement, livestock and feeds movement, intra-city transport, mass transit, like Lagos mass transit train, like Port Harcourt Aba, intercity passenger services, Lagos to Kano, to back to Lagos, Lagos to Ilorin, back to Lagos, Ofa, to Kano, Mina, to Kaduna, to Mina. All those are the narrow gauge. Kano, Nguru, Port Harcourt, Kano, Zaria, Kaura, Namoda, Zaria. Then the excursions, the standard gauge, I've already told you about Abuja, Kaduna, to Abuja, Warri to Itabel, and back to Warri. And now we're about to start the Lagos district. Now, let me tell you how the number of cases we've had, the vandalizations we've had. There is the Lagos district, and I must, again, let me say what I will say, to, part of what I will say tomorrow. The guys that are found in the Lagos to Ibadan appear to be different Nigerians. Not one day, even though somebody has said, oh, they stole some few things from them recently, but not one day did we have community problem. Nobody ever came to us and said, we are Lagosians, or we are from Ifa, or whatever. You've not paid us money for land acquisition or whatever. In fact, even those that got affected by flood as a result of the elevation of the gradient wrote to us. When somebody asked me, why are these people not fighting directly? I said, they're educated, so they know how to write letters. But it's not true. There are also people there who are not educated, and they're not vandalizing, they're not attacking us, they're not robbing us, but they're quiet from Lagos up to Ibadan. I'm not saying it's only in Lagos. In fact, I expect that because of the cosmopolitan nature of Lagos, we'll have had challenges. But we didn't have, and we've completed, we commissioned on Thursday by the grace of God. So in Lagos district, the whole of Western district, we have just one case. But now listen, the whole of Northwest, 31. And you know what, Northwest, right? Want me to call them so that you can shame them. The whole of Northern district, 10. The whole of Northeastern district, that's where we have the worst case. No, not there, North Central is the worst case. Northeastern district, you have 43. North Central district, where you have Jos and all those people, you have 50. Eastern district, you have 36. Abuja to Kaduna, 13. That's worse. What they do in Abuja to Kaduna is they're not cutting off the track. They're stealing, what they call that pin? There's a pin used to hold this thing down. So if we have changed up to 10,000 of those things. You have to make sure every day before the train runs, we have to walk all that track to make sure that the track is safe. Yes, you may say it's creating employment for the rural people because we have to employ them to walk the track and see whether those things are there. But if those things are not there, and then a train comes, only God knows what will happen. It could also derail. So in Abuja to Kaduna alone, we have 13 cases. Warri to Itabe, that's one that was surprising because all the cases seem to be on narrow gauge. But Warri to Itabe is standard gauge. So in Warri to Itabe, we have had 2 cases. Lagos to Ibadan, 0. That's the standard gauge, 0. Which confirms the statement I've been making since we started that, listen, that those people appear to be different type of Nigerians. Well, you ask me what efforts are we making. We have, Nigerian Local Corporation has its own police, just like Nigerian Post Authority has its own police. So we are doing a lot, but not enough. That means that we have to look for equipment that will secure the line just to make sure that people are kept alive. Some people have recommended, and I think I'm keeping to the 5 minutes. Some people have recommended that, look, these people are killing people. If accidents happen, people will die. So we should go back to the National Assembly. I'm sure the Senate President's representative is here. And pass a law that does not only criminalize the action, but consequences should be death. Because they are going to kill human beings too. If armed robbery, whether successful or not, whether you kill somebody or not, is life imprisonment or death, I can't remember. Why should people who cut off tracks, I don't mind road, because if you go to road, you may slow down, you may stop. In the case of train, no. I mean, the automatic brake system in every car can manage situations. But there is no automatic brake system in the train. Once it's running, it's running. So you have that problem. And finally, before I leave here, there's another group of people. They are both in Port Harcourt and Lagos. They have converted. If you see the new tracks, you think we built it in 1901. They have converted the track in the whole of Lagos. Well, I've said that they don't. They've never attacked us. They've never stolen. But at least this one, they're misbehaving. You will see shops on the track. You will see people, restaurants on the track. Once the train is coming, you blare the horn, we do like 5 kilometers per hour. As you blow the horn, they will just quickly move the thing out. Once we pass, they move it back. I have engaged the Lagos State Governor. I have told him the solution. The solution is put them in jail. Because it's only mad people that will go to where, you know, just assume the train is doing 100 meters, 100 kilometers per hour. All of them will die. But for those people, you don't need to kill them. All you need to do is pass a law, put them in jail. I'm sure if you take 15, 20, 30 persons to court and they are found guilty and put in jail, they will not come again. Now, they are taking, people are seizing our land, they're not acquiring our land. Go to my one market. We're going to rebuild the rail from Port Harcourt to Maiduguri. They've converted the entire railway land into my one market in Port Harcourt. All that, and not just Port Harcourt, it's everywhere. All that we need to do. But we need people to leave our tracks alone for safety purposes. Thank you very much.